Hey, what's up guys, it's Renaldo here. So this video is going to focus on how the government has decided to shut down the beaches in South Africa. They've pretty much come out and said, your festive season is klaar, done, nga, murtu. And all of that because they are incompetent. Now, why, you might ask? Well, it's day 263 of the lockdown. And yet, on day 263 of the lockdown, the government has decided to close the beaches. And they blame the public at large for the reason that they have to shut down the beaches. But yet, if you look at the policies that the government has implemented themselves and how they have patrolled and managed the situation, you can clearly see that the problem isn't necessarily just with the public that aren't adhering, but it's also with the government not patrolling and controlling and influencing these individuals in a manner that tells them that what they are doing is wrong. So now we're in a situation where the masses are being punished because a handful of people are acting absolutely idiotic. But to get back to the beaches. So Cyril Ramaphosa came out and said, well, we are going to shut down the Eastern Cape beaches and the Garden Route beaches. And oh, Durban, by the way, you know, your province is really problematic. And every single year when photos come out of beaches that are completely overwhelmed, then KZN always is at the forefront. But what we're going to do is we're going to shut down the Eastern Cape and the Garden Route completely from the 16th until the 3rd of January. Completely shut it down. But Durban, who's the most problematic, oh no, you know what? You can stay open, but we're only going to shut you down on the 16th, on Christmas Day, the 26th, and then the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd of January. That's what we're going to do. How the hell does that make sense? You've got your provinces that really aren't that problematic with regards to the secluded beaches that they have, and also in the way that you can control specific days and close them and shut them down for specific days, but no. The Eastern Cape and the Garden Route is completely shut down because you know what? They can't manage it. They can't patrol it. So instead of them doing their jobs, they'd rather just ruin it for everybody and say, nobody's allowed on the beach. And another reason that this is completely, absolutely bullshit and pathetic is the fact that you are shutting down a place that has got fresh air and that you can actually go and swim and adhere to social distancing. But yet for shopping centers, for restaurants, for rallies and protests, these same rules don't apply. So the law-abiding citizens that would actually like to enjoy their summer and would like to adhere to social distancing, wearing a mask and following all procedures, aren't allowed to go to a beach because the beach is the death zone. A shopping center? Fine. A tavern? Fine. A bottle store? Fine. The beach, death zone. And yes, I can already hear people saying, but Renaldo, do you know what it's like on New Year's Eve and on the 1st of December and on opening of the season? Yeah, I get it. Shut the beach down for those days. That's fine. Shut the beaches down for those days. But to completely shut down the beaches from the 16th of December until the 3rd of Jan for the Eastern Cape and for the Garden Route is absolutely absurd. These small towns need tourism. The government is literally killing the tourism industry with these regulations that they've put out. So just to put it into perspective for you, a handful of people have ruined it for millions, literally. And the saddest part is, if the government only implemented what they said they want to implement and actually have people patrolling, then we wouldn't be in this situation. So make no mistake that this is completely a government failure. If the government had enough police officers on the ground, or even the army, to make sure that social distancing is adhered to and that people are wearing masks where they are supposed to wear masks, then we wouldn't be in this situation. But because the government is incompetent and they can't provide healthcare effectively and they can't provide policing or an army that's effective, this is where we are right now, in which the prime tourist season in South Africa, beaches are completely closed. And do you think tourists are going to go and say, well, you know, let's go there and enjoy the beautiful beaches while we can look at it and not actually enjoy it? Hell no. They're going to stay right where they are, whether that is overseas or whether that is staying in Gauteng, Bloemfontein, or wherever you are, if your plans were to come to a coastal town. You're not going to come to a coastal town just to look at the ocean. So millions and millions of rands are being lost because of government incompetence. So to end off this video, an absolutely amazing decision by Cyril Ramaphosa on how to destroy an economy. Because like I said, tens of thousands of people are going to lose their jobs because they can't trade during the festive season. So many places around the Garden Route and specifically in the Eastern Cape that are coastal towns won't be able to trade at the capacity that they will usually trade because of a handful of people that can't adhere to the regulations, but also because of government incompetence. And that's the thing that you need to take away here. It's not necessarily the people's fault. It is definitely the government's fault. Because if they had the hospitals ready, if they had the police ready, if they had enough police, and if they had the army ready, then we wouldn't be in the situation where we have beaches that are shut down for close to 3 weeks. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by clicking the join button below. Also, please be sure to check out my merch, tsakclothing.com. If you see something there that you like, then please be sure to buy it. Please be sure to subscribe, and if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so that you can be notified of my future uploads. Also, please be sure to drop a comment below as well as smashing that like button. And lastly, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.
You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I wear my massacre. I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say I wear my massacre. I wear my massacre.